Stradivarius made a lot of violins. Only a few exist to this day. Nobody's been able to duplicate what he was able to do. 300 years after his death, we still have violins that no other violin can touch in their sound quality. They always wondered why his was much more capable of having this great sound. What they found was he was a very poor man, and the only wood that he could find to build his violins were the wood that was taken out of ships that had been decommissioned or were no longer capable of going out into the sea, and the wood of them sat in these rotting harbors, and he would take that wood because he couldn't afford any other wood, and he would make his violins out of it. So here you had these polluted harbors, you had these ships, this wood that had been soaked in sludge, and he took this wood that had been affected by decay and infested with microbes, and yet they found that this wood, the microbes that ate the cells of this wood hollow, caused thousands of hollow chambers in the wood and transformed the wood from being worthless empty spaces into resonating cathedrals of sound. In other words, they rescued these scraps of wood which had no value in them, and even the damage that had been done to them in their previous existence was taken by the master and reshaped into something that was greater than anything imaginable. And you know, that's what's true in our life as well. Even all the sin that you've been through, the damage that sin has done, God can take that and resonate from your life something beautiful. That is what the master is capable of doing. But it all begins with understanding that, that you're not a castaway, you're not worthless, that sin no longer has the boundary line in your life like it used to have. To know that, to know that sin was paid for, to understand the truths of that, and then to realize, reckon it's true for you. If this applies to you, you can take it and cash that check. And then whenever that moment comes, when sin says, come this way, you say, no, I'm not presenting myself to you anymore. I'm presenting myself to God. I belong to the master now. Something amazing has changed in my life.